close your eyes, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Come here. 11, 12, 13.
Hi guys, see you again. I'm Coach Benny from Tokyo. Today we're gonna talk about one topic, how to floating in Japanese way. Jadi apa kabar semua? Saya Coach Benny dari Tokyo. Hari ini kita akan berbicara tentang topik mengapung yang terkenal di Jepang. Oke, okay? Ini diajarkan dari murid-murid SD sampai SMA. Ya. This topic is very famous in Japan. They learn from the elementary school, high school, and it's a bit some back throwback to a couple years ago when the tsunami hit this country. There's so many kids, so many people surviving with this simple of skill. You know, you won't believe there's one school almost floated in the water. And because of the kid know what to do with this, and most of them is survive. Yeah, it's very famous story here. Jadi ini kembali ke kisah berapa saat yang silam waktu tsunami mendatang ya Jepang. Itu banyak sekali orang yang selamat dengan skill ini. Oke, okay? Ada satu sekolah yang kena banjir semuanya. Tsunami datang itu tenggelam semua. Tapi anak-anak muridnya selamat dalam satu ruangan dengan skill ini. Skill ini mereka sebut uitemate in Japanese ya. This skill in Japanese they call uitemate. Simply how to do floating on your back and grab anything you can to survive for couple hour to save your energy until help coming, alright, the rescue coming. Jadi skill ini sudah menyelamatkan banyak nyawa untuk mengapung, menghemat tenaga waktu kejadian-kejadian yang tidak diinginkan seperti tsunami atau banjir menjelang bantuan datang. Ya, di Jepang disebut uitemate. Alright guys, let's go back go to the business. Alright, I'm gonna show you how look like the people say. With the mat, it's like this one. As you can see, I can float as long as I can. When you know the technique, I can save my energy, a little bit rest. Jadi bisa ibu-ibu bapak, bapak-bapak sekalian lihat saya bisa floating selama yang saya suka menjelang menghemat energi saya atau menjelang bantuan datang ya seperti. So guys, this the technique is actually is you have to. This is the step. The step is first you have to lift your chin up a little bit and look it up to the sky. Look it up to the sky and breathing normally. Yeah, breathing normal. It's gonna be like this. Up. Jadi ibu-ibu bapak-bapak sekalian, step pertamanya harus dagu kita harus diangkat, ya begini. Lihat ke atas. Okay, the first step is lift your chin up and look it up. Alright, head back a little bit. Just keep it nice, seperti begini dah. Sama lagi. Step, you have to open your arm like, just spread your arm like this. Step kedua, rentangkan tangan di air. That's it, and then last one, you might spread up your leg a little bit, your leg like this, so you can bend it up or separate, spread up, open, okay? We call starfish position when I teaching kid. Jadi step berikutnya, kaki kita agak dibuka sedikit. Ya, kalau saya ngajar anak-anak itu biasanya saya sebut starfish position, seperti ini. Seperti ini, bisa dimulai dari lantai, taruh kaki dulu di sini, terus di push. So you guys, I call it starfish position, it's just like this. You can start like this and put your leg in the wall. In emergency situation, you can just drop anything, maybe like bottle of water or whatsoever to support you. Jadi di waktu emergency, bisa aja kita pakai apa aja yang napo. Something floating, you can use it to support your body. For example, bottle of water, mineral water, whatsoever. Jadi bisa dipakai apa aja yang napo. Botol air, botol mineral. Contoh, I give you example like this one. See, I get a little pouring, I can use it. Just imagine something float, right? Anything. Jadi, bayangkan aja ini sesuatu yang ngapu, apa aja. Ini bisa dipakai untuk membantu tubuh kita ngapu ya, seperti botol air atau apa. Look like simply you can use like this. Thank you. can all with the simple thing like this, I can survive, I can float for a couple hour and save my energy until rescue coming. Jadi dengan hal yang mengapung, benda mengapung kecil seperti ini, saya bisa membantu saya sekali untuk mengapung beberapa jam sampai saya dapat pertolongan. Dan bisa aja ditaruh di perut begini atau di bawah begini, di sini, di mana yang comfortable, ya, yang menolong. So you can just grab in here, guys, or in lower body, wherever you feel comfortable to keep you. You can do like this. Yeah, look this. You can do like this. Alright, this is Uitemate in Japan. It saved so many lives. Simple skill but really useful. It's worth it. It's been helped so many people life. Yeah, saved so many people life. Yeah, itulah yang kita sebut Uitemate di Jepang, yang sudah menyelamatkan banyak ribuan nyawa. Banyak menyelamatkan nyawa anak-anak sekolah waktu kejadian tsunami kemarin. Yeah, simple skill tapi sangat berguna sekali. Alright, as usual guys, if you feel this video is benefit for everyone, you just share. Alright, asking some question in the comment or hit button subscribe so you get some notification. I'm gonna upload so many video, different skill, different way, from the baby, kiddos, until adult. Yap. Seperti biasa, bagikan videonya agar bermanfaat pada yang lain. Klik berlangganan biar ada notification, atau kalau ada pertanyaan atau maunya gimana, tulis aja di kolom komen. Alright, I'm Coach Benny from Tokyo. As usual, stay healthy, stay happy. Good night.